Respected Union Minister for Electronics and Information Technology, Law and Justice, Communications, Shri Ravishankar Prasad Ji. Respected Minister Shri Sanjay Dhotre Ji. My esteemed colleague, senior colleague, Shri Amitabh Kant Ji, under whose constant guidance and support we have been able to give a very good shape to these very ambitious schemes. My colleague, Shri Saurabh Gaur Ji, and people from the industry, media persons, eminent people. It's a great pleasure for me today to be here and to be able to present the contours of three very important schemes: the production-linked incentive scheme, the scheme for production of electronic components and semiconductors, and the electronic manufacturing cluster scheme with a new twist, with a new new fervor. So I would like to take you through a very short presentation. As our Honorable Minister mentioned, in 2014-15, our production in all of electronics was $29 billion. And imports at that point of time in electronics was $38 billion. And in 4 years' time, the production went up to $70 billion. Imports also went up because many of the things that we produce require components to be imported. But imports went up to $57 billion from 38, and the production went up to $70 billion from 29. So we, if we see what are the different sectors in which this growth happened, a little bit of growth happened in computer hardware from $2.8 to $3.3 billion. More growth happened in strategic electronics, including defense electronics, from $2.4 billion to $4 billion. Further growth happened in consumer electronics from $8.5 to $11.2 billion. Electronic components grew from $6 to $9.6 during this time. Industrial electronics grew even better, from $6 to $11.5. But the best growth was from $2.9 billion in mobile devices to $24.3 billion in mobile devices over this four-year period. It was a huge growth that happened. And India's share in global manufacturing in electronics went up from 1.3 to 3%. And exports were somewhat flat in the early years. Then in the last year, which I have shown here, it went up from $6.4 to $8.8 billion, showing an increase of 38% in 1 year. So all this has built a very strong foundation on which we are now trying to build something extraordinarily large. Our aim is that India should be a global hub for mobile phones and for component manufacturing. And we should manufacture so much that it is not just for Indian market. A good part of it will also go into exports, so that we join the global value chain in a very significant manner. We are trying to attract some of the best firms globally. Many of them are already in India. Many of them have started production in India. We expect them to make use of this opportunity to grow their business many fold. And finally, we want mobile phones to become our largest exported item, with Make in India being the theme. Though we ourselves are a huge market, but mobile phones have a tremendous opportunity of making available mobile phones manufactured in India to satisfy the demand across the globe. This, we hope, will help us increase our GDP, improve taxation, improve tax revenue, and also have a huge impact on jobs. Over the past 4 years, what has grown, first of all, the mobile handsets, which I had already indicated. LCD and LED TVs production also grew very quickly. LED products grew extremely fast, and in many of these we are also active now in the export markets. The sectors which are emerging as strong players, apart from mobile phones, are the sectors of automobile electronics, medical electronics, industrial electronics, strategic electronics, which includes defense, and telecom products as well. So these are the sectors for all of which what we are going to do now will make and give it a huge impetus, not just to mobile phones, but to all of these sectors together. Mobile manufacturing, as our Honorable Minister has already mentioned, the mobile manufacturing units went up almost 100-fold. The number of mobile handsets produced went up very rapidly, and the value of handsets also grew almost 10-fold in this period. There are three very important schemes that are now being unveiled. The schemes were notified on 2nd of April, but now the guidelines have also been approved. So now the schemes will be open for companies to apply and to make
from today itself.
Wow. And I will show the websites also where the details of those schemes are available, because those are ready to go. The three schemes are the production linked incentive scheme for large scale mobile manufacturing, also to give support to component manufacturing and to ATMP process in case of semiconductors. The scheme for promotion of manufacturing of components and semiconductors, again this is a capex subsidy scheme for the entire supply chain. Now this is where it is components not just for mobile phones, but for all the mobile sectors or all the electronic sectors. The components are more or less similar, so once we have the supply chain in India, we can hope for a huge growth in each of those sectors. The third one is very large electronic manufacturing clusters, each of which will have at least one anchor industry, a large industry, on the model of what we have seen in case of Maruti Suzuki or others, where a major company comes in, and along with that the ancillaries, the supply chain also comes in alongside, close to that area. And the overall incentives would go up to almost $6.5 billion or more. The production linked incentive will offer an incentive of 4% to 6% of the production as an incentive over a period of 5 years. The target segments for this are mobile phones and electronic components. The outlay for this particular scheme is about 41,000 crores. The application dates are open from now till 31st of July. The base year for this is 2019-20. What we incentivize is not the overall production. What we incentivize is production over and above the production levels that were achieved in the base year. So if you have achieved something in 2019-20, that is treated as the base. What is it that you will produce as an incremental production over that? And very steep expectation is there. For whatever you produce on top of the base is what gets incentivized. In this, the incentives will be applicable from 1st of August this year itself. So we expect many of the companies are in good readiness today to go quickly, and we expect that they will be in proper production cycle at the earliest during this year itself. The portal that we have set up, IFCI, is taken by us as our partner for rolling out the scheme, and IFCI has already prepared the portal for this, where the guidelines are available, which is ready to receive the applications. This is a quick screenshot for that. This is once again, this is the application form, and many of the details by going to this portal can be taken from that portal. We are all in readiness, whether it is Invest India, whether it is Ministry of Electronics and IT, whether it is IFCI, all of us are in readiness to do handholding, to help the investors understand what needs to be done and to help you, make you comfortable while applying for the scheme and make you comfortable and successful when you actually come in and invest.